We found a treasure trove of Atari 2600 cartridges. We hear that there's thousands of them down there. We pulled out, I want to say there's probably a couple dozen by the end of the first day, and I know the team is there today pulling even more out.
And it's in a landfill site.
It is absolutely in a landfill site on the outskirts of a small town in New Mexico. It is. It was positively arid out there.
There were rumors, weren't there, for a long time that this had been done. What led you? What led to this particular site and this discovery?
Back in the 80s, over 30 years ago, the backstory is that Atari had rushed this particular game, this E.T. game, into production, and the developer, whom I had a lovely chat with when I was down at the site, he was there, had about 5 weeks to make it. Now, by any stretch of the imagination, 5 weeks is nowhere near enough time to make a game at all. So the game was released, and there was a lot of things that happened in this game that kind of were really bad. For one, the game only had 5 weeks. Number two, they produced far more cartridges for the 2600 than there were even in existence at that time. And then, of course, the game itself was not well received, and Atari decided to take the loss and cart them out into the desert and put them into a landfill.
You'd think they'd, I don't know, burn them or throw them away in a kind of more obvious and public way than to bury them in the desert and just hope they wouldn't be found.
I can't speak for Atari because I certainly wasn't with them way back then, but I think there was a little bit of shame involved.